Once upon a time, way back in the day, people sang Christmas songs. It was Christmas songs at church. Christmas songs in the home.
Red-nosed reindeer had a very shiny nose.
People even went door to door singing Christmas songs on the street.
Oh, jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle all the way.
All in all, Christmas songs became a cheap yet effective way to spread cheer and joy throughout the land during this most wonderful time of the year.
It's the most wonderful time of the year.
See what I mean? The trend even caught on at the North Pole, where Santa's elves would sing while working on the toy assembly line.
We wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
All this singing helped speed toy production along, and everyone was merry. That is, until that year that one particular elf began singing along with her fellow elves.
We wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Her name was Caroline, and she could not find a tune in a bucket full of music.
Oh, my ears hurt.
And there was another problem. Some of the notes that Caroline would hit would take out a whole row of freshly made Christmas ornaments.
Oops, sorry.
Now, elves are generally happy, jolly sorts, and they couldn't bring themselves to just tell Caroline to shut the hell up. Instead, they all just stopped singing on the production line, which saved their ears and the ornaments, but proved to be dreadfully boring.
What's new?
Not much. What's new with you?
Funny you should ask. It's this toy new I just finished carving.
Oh, it's a new. I thought it was a boa constrictor with elephantiasis. No, actually, I thought it was an antelope. Have you ever seen your antelope? She can't elope. She's got too much room. What was the question?
After a while, even Santa noticed that the elves were their usual happy selves. So he talked to the head elf, Jerome.
Jerome? I've noticed the elves aren't their usual happy selves. Is there a problem?
Well, Santa, it's just that we can't sing while we work anymore.
It's those Killjoy music publishers demanding their royalties, isn't it?
No, Santa, it's not that. Although their fees did go up again this year.
Oh, they're such poopy heads. There, I said it. Sorry, Mrs. Claus.
There, there. Calm down, dear. There's no need to resort to a potty mouth when criticizing those obvious assholes.
Santa, I hate to say it, but the reason that we're not singing while we work anymore is Caroline. Her singing is so bad, it's breaking eardrums and shattering ornaments. But she means well, and we don't want to make her feel bad, so we all just decided to stop singing.
Well, can you whistle while you work?
No. Dwarves do that, not elves.
Well, let me see what I can do.
The very next day, music returned to the workshop.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Andy Williams.
It's the most wonderful time of the year.
There you go, Jerome. I've hired Andy Williams to sing to you elves while you're making the toys.
Thanks, Santa.
It's the most wonderful time of the year.
Good evening, and welcome to our Christmas party.
And all was well again at the North Pole. The happy elves made a record number of toys, and by Christmas Eve, all were ready to be loaded on Santa's sleigh. That is when the great ice storm hit.
Oh, this is a bad one. Worse even than that foggy night when I asked Rudolph to guide my sleigh.
Santa, the sleigh is covered in ice. We can't take off.
Oh, dear. Not even Rudolph's nose can help with this one. Oh, but maybe there's someone who can.
And with that, Santa ran to Arsenio Hall. Oh, that's the dormitory where the elves live.
Caroline, Caroline! Where's Caroline?
Right here, Santa.
Oh, Caroline, it's been brought to my attention that you have a singing voice that can shatter glass.
Yes? I guess I do.
I'm told you took out a whole warehouse full of ornaments.
Yes, and all those bottles of 100-year-old scotch as well.
And that was you?
Calm down, dear. No need to get all riled up over this stupid little bitch.
Yes, of course. Caroline, I have a favor to ask.
Certainly, Santa. And please call me Carol. All my friends do.
Oh, very well. Then, Carol, with your voice such a fright, will you free my sleigh tonight?
Yes, of course, Santa.
So they all ran outside to where Santa's sleigh was covered in ice. Carol let loose with the highest note she could hit. And just like that, the ice shattered. And Santa's sleigh was free to deliver toys to all the good little girls and boys of the world.
I did it!
Of course you did, dear. Now come inside and I'll get you some hot chocolate. Of course, I won't be able to put any scotch in it. We seem to be out.
Thank you, Carol. You'll go down in history. Ho, 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 Merry Christmas!
And don't you know Santa was right? Because she did go down in history. You see, every year, we don't just sing Christmas songs, now do we? No. We sing Christmas carols.
Come on, y'all. It's Christmas time. I know you're out there. I hear your reindeer. I see the snow where your boots have been. I'm gonna show them so they will know then. Their love will grow when they believe.
Happiest of holidays to you and yours from Don Bryan, Matt Kaplan, Mary Lyon, Don Rooney, Lauren Rooney, John Timpane, and all of us at the Musical Innertube.
Everybody. Oh, shit. That's right. I'm supposed to help Santa load his sleigh. I'm late.